In the previous video, we changed the behavior of the actors by adding more instances of actors, adding goals, and changing the actor's speed. In this video, we'll add some obstacles and then send the final crowd to Maya. Now that our businessmen are running at a good speed, let's stop them from going through the fountain. To have the actors consider the fountain as an obstacle, you need to draw a wall around it to delimit its area. Walls are special polygon mesh objects that are set up in the ice tree and are the only type of object that actors will recognize as obstacles. Choose Crowd Draw Wall and draw a wall around the fountain. Press the Shift key while you're drawing to change its height interactively. It's best to have the wall at least the height of the actor's hip so that it can be detected properly. You can also set the parameters in the Set Wall Data property editor that appears. Move the wall over so that it's centered on the fountain. When you play the simulation, you can see that there are still some actors going through the wall or getting stuck on it. To help prevent this, there are a few things you can do. You can increase the push factor around the wall to make the exit points stick out more. These tell the actors where they should go to get around the wall. We want the actors to go only to the right of the fountain, so let's select only one exit point. This may be defined as either the left or right side, depending on how you drew the wall. That certainly helps direct traffic, but there are still some actors penetrating or getting stuck on the wall. You can also create a larger personal space buffer around the actors so that they don't get too close to the walls or to each other. To do this, open the Initialize Collision Avoidance node and increase the actor thickness value. But most importantly, we'll increase the wall's interaction limit value so that the actors can anticipate the wall sooner and change their speed and direction accordingly. That works well, but there are still a few actors coming back to the wall and getting stuck there. This is because a wall's exit points act a bit like goals. The actors are attracted to them in order to get around the wall. Even though the actor's ultimate destination is always the final goal object, the exit points can distract the actors from their goals. It's best to move the goals so that they're not too close to a wall's exit points. You can hide the wall, and the actors will still respond to it as if it's there. Another type of obstacle that the actors need to detect is the ground on which they're walking, which is called a terrain in CrowdFX. Simply drag the ground object into the terrain group in the crowd model, and the actors will detect it properly. You could also select the ground and choose Crowd Add Terrain to do this. The actor's feet are controlled in the Behavior Ice Tree by the Stick to Ground node. It sends a raycast from each actor to detect the terrain surface, and each actor's rig is adjusted so that the feet stay on the ground. The plaza is flat, so you don't notice much difference with its floor set as the terrain. But if the surface was uneven, you'd see the actors move over its contours correctly, even as it deformed over time. The crowd simulation is looking good, with everything set up as it should be. We're ready to export the single crowd object and its cache file to Maya. Make sure to click the All button so that all frames in the timeline are played back and cached. Select the crowd model and choose Crowd Export Crowd as FBX. This exports the single actor copies mesh in an FBX file and creates a geometry cache of the simulation. Select Geometry Cache File and make sure that Crowd Actor Copies is the group. And select centimeters for the scale, as we used for the plasma model. Click OK and Softimage caches the crowd simulation. In Maya, the plasma model is already in place, so now we can import the crowd. We already set the frame rate to be 30 frames per second, which is the frame rate that we used for the crowd simulation in Softimage. Choose File Import and load in the CrowdFX file. Make sure that the geometry cache file is selected and that the units are in centimeters. The crowd needs to be at the same starting location in the plaza in relation to where it was in Softimage so that the collision areas match up. Change the end frame to 1000 so that it's the same number of frames as it was in Softimage. Now play the simulation to see the actors moving across the plaza in Maya just as they did in Softimage. If you need to make changes to the simulation, you can go back to your crowd scene in Softimage, make the changes, and then export the crowd again. In other videos, we'll explore more details of CrowdFX when we set up a crowd simulation from scratch and customize the actor's behavior in many different ways.